So the UC Davis World Water Initiative inspires me because it's an opportunity to change California, to change the water management approaches in the US and worldwide. There is the need for this, desperate need on a global basis, and there's the opportunity.
We need water in our future. With that comes the responsibility to our generation in the next generation to figure out ways to manage that resource towards all the benefits that we're enjoying today.
But if you compare California to other water-stressed parts of the world, arid places will have a lot of variability, floods and droughts, we're kind of the envy of the world.
It's estimated that about 3/4 of all jobs worldwide depend on water supply and water services. 40% of the world's food depends on irrigation, water supply. So these are very, very relevant issues.
I don't think I'll ever look at a water management problem the same ever again because of the interactions I've had with the other scientists who work here and the kinds of applied problems we've worked on here. There's no lack of expertise. And because the barriers have been broken down between all of our disciplines, every day we're seeing something from a new perspective.
It seems clear that there's something in the water at Davis or something in the ethos or the culture that encourages and allows or hires scientists who have a gift for being able to translate complex scientific engineering or legal principles into accessible language for folks.
We imagine Davis as a center of water education for the whole world. We imagine those students in our labs, we imagine teaching them on the rivers, on the floodplains, on the dams, on the coastlines of California, learning about water where it happens, and exporting that expertise, placing those people learned in the California approaches to water management. You know, a single fellowship, a single student can make a world of difference.
I think what UC Davis can bring to the issues that we face, and this is true with NGOs as well, is a sense of scientific rigor and integrity and how to approach a problem in a data-based way. What I think the NGO world, the private sector, and we can give to UC Davis is practical examples of where they can be helpful so that the work they do is going to have the added benefit of being reality-based as opposed to theoretical.
UC Davis has very quickly become the hub of a global network of scientists who are taking on some of the most entrenched water quality problems and water management problems all over the world. The Yolo Bypass that we're working on is one of the perfect examples of where farmers plant rice on the Yolo Bypass. It's also used as one of the biggest flood control pieces of infrastructure we have to protect the Sacramento Valley, but it's also one of the most successful floodplain and bird habitats we have. And it's right smack dab in the middle of a metropolitan area.
And so that's where this idea of a World Water Center becomes very central. We have, in fact, learned a lot here, and we have still a lot to learn. And we can be a hub for that exchange that needs to happen between research leaders, policy and decision maker leaders here in California, locally within California, but also across the United States and around the world.
Underrepresented communities, economically depressed communities, are disproportionately hit by water crises of all kinds. So one of the proposed elements of the World Water Big Idea, the new initiative, is water without borders. And that is the idea to provide scientific expertise in the aftermath of water crises around the world. So a lot of the infrastructure is already in place. UC Davis has the manpower, we have the expertise, but we cannot make this vision of water without borders happen without resources. We need to have equipment and opportunities to move when this action happens.
We need partners to do this. Engagement takes partners. Partners with the agencies, the government officials, the NGOs, the stakeholders that are involved in these problems. And UC Davis, I think, is in a position to be extraordinarily effective and to bring a lot of other people along with us.
The Big Idea inspires me because of its potential to build a global community of scientists who have the character and commitment to solve some of the world's most difficult water resources problems and some of the most entrenched global conflicts. And through doing so, we then create a community who inspires a whole new generation of scientists to join us and be part of those solutions.